In today's video, we're gonna go over the best web-based PDF editor to make our PDFs accessible. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. The best web-based editor that I have found for PDFs that can make them accessible is called Venngage. They have all the important features that you would need to design a document. And to begin, you can simply go into templates or designs and choose your starting file. So if I select this templates button and then I select accessible, I can begin with using an accessible template. And I'm just gonna choose one of these templates, and it's pretty quick to jump in here and start editing our PDF. I'm going to start editing by double clicking into this text box, and I'm going to type something like accessibility equals usability. And in this content box, I'm going to say top tips for accessibility, no matter the platform. And one way we can start applying our accessibility is by selecting the content box, and then in the tags panel, we can choose what type of tag we want to apply. For this example, I'm simply going to make it an H1, but we could also test our other one over here where we have this accessibility equals usability. We can make that a paragraph tag, and we can now start moving through the content. Let's first add in our text content. So this set boundaries text, if I go up to the tags panel, it's already marked as an H2. Same with that content and prioritize self-care. So whatever text I write in here, it's already gonna be tagged with my H2 contents. One thing we could put in here is use styles. That's important. And then we could double click this text and let's give the description for using styles. Now we could update the next heading and we'll say use alternate text. And then we'll put in our description. Now we can go over to the final box and we'll do check color contrast and then put in our description. Next, I don't love these icons, so I'm going to select it and then select replace image. Now I can either choose different icons from within the Venngage library, or I could upload my own. Let's just search to see if there's one for style. I love that it's pulling up outfits and things like that, but I actually like these tees. That sort of represents like how to change a style. It's primarily for Microsoft, but that works for me. Let's click the other one, or let's now add alt text. So I'm gonna select that object and we're gonna say alt text. We're gonna leave it as decorative. That's perfect. Now let's change this image that I have for the alt text area. And I'm going to type in alt text for the icons. Let's see what we can find. I love that there are some buttons in here for alt text. So I'm going to simply select that. And then we could check the alt text of it. It's already marked as decorative. Now let's change this one for color contrast. I'm going to search for a color. Let's just type color contrast to see what we find. All right, there's a cool graphic and I wanna just move it up a little, or I can change the shape of it. And then let's check the alt text again. Perfect. Now we can go down to resources and support. This should probably be an H2 tag, and it is. Excellent. We then have some hyperlink text in here, a phone number. We wanna make sure that we have our hyperlinks properly formatted. So I'm gonna select that text, and it has the text right here. And we're gonna put in our mail to address, hr@duoanalytics.com, and hit save. Now this is like a dummy document, so I would put in my own email address if that's what I was trying to do. We could also replace out like this logo down there, and I could swap it with my accessibility guy logo instead, but it doesn't quite fit, so I'm just gonna delete it. And then we have this other element in here where we can select it, do alt text, and it has Oakwood Medical Research Foundation logo, perfect. Let's check the QR code. We wanna check the alt text on this. A QR code linking to Venngage.com, perfect. Now let's actually check the link of the URL. Perfect, and we have that URL activated in there. And so now this little worksheet is pretty much accessible, but here's where I really love using Venngage. I could go to the file button and we could select accessibility, and we could do a whole bunch of stuff in here. We could edit the tag order, set the document language, and check accessibility. So let's do that. Let's first go over to the tag order, and I basically want to make sure that the content flows from the top to the bottom. So our first text area here, accessibility equals usability, perfect. Top tips, use styles, the style text, alt text, and I'm just clicking through this to make sure everything is going in order, and it appears that it is, so that's amazing.
Now let's run the checker and we're going to check our design. So Venngage actually runs an automated scan on our color contrast, which it does currently pass. It also passes our text size. And if we had tables in the document, it runs a scan for that too. Next, we have manual reviews. This is great to remind your user like what you need to check for. So we wanna check all of our graphics, which we've already done. So I'm just gonna select that option. We've already validated the reading order. We have ensured that our headings are in here, but when I select this heading content, it actually pulls all of them up. So I can zoom in just a little bit, and in the top left corner of each of the boxes, I can see the tag type. We have P tag, H1, H2P, 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 and so on. So I'm gonna mark this as it follows best practices. Then we have our use of color. I am not relying on color in my document, so we can mark that as passing. We do not have any images of text. We will mark that passing. We are not using generic link text, which is perfect. We'll mark that as completed. We want to check our document title, which is this top level content up at the top of the Venngage toolbar. And I'm just going to put like a top tips for accessibility. And then let's set our document language. Right now it's defaulted to English. We'll mark that completed. Oh, I forgot to mark the document title is complete. Perfect. And now our document is fully accessible. So let's go ahead and download it as a PDF file. We can open up our PDF and now let's review it. Step one, open up the tags panel. Now we can go into the tags and walk the tags tree and look at this. We have a heading one, H2 tag. It's literally like perfect. All right, now let's go ahead and launch the PAC 2024 tool and we'll test our file in there. And it looks like we're missing an alternate description for something, for our annotation. This is a newer thing that's been coming through with the pack checker. To fix it, we're gonna do print production, pre-flight, and then select the single fix element, and we're gonna do annotation, and we want this option create content entry for link annotations, and then we'll save our file. But that's the only thing we have to do to make this fully compliant. Let's go ahead and test this one more time. And now we have a passing PDF, UA, and WCAG report. That concludes today's video on the best web editor for PDF to export accessible PDFs. If you want to check out a free trial to Venngage, there's a link in the description of this video. And if you want to find out how I can help you tackle your bigger accessibility problems, there's a link in the description for that too. And as always, I could be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.